A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th March, on the front page you have gunman on the rampage kills 49 in New Zealand mosque. So right-wing ultras used semi-automatic weapons, and here people who were praying as such on the Friday prayers were fell victims to this attack. The attacker live streamed footage of his carnage too. Then next is, Supreme Court issues notice to Election Commission on plea to verify at least 50% VVPATs. So the Supreme Court bench has sought an officer to assist it in the next hearing. So it wants the Election Commission's view on how can it go ahead, the VVPAT trail, how can it be used, because what the Election Commission has notified is that it would do one random VVPAT verification. But opposition parties who have approached the Supreme Court have said that they want at least 50% VVPATs in each constituency being verified. Then below you have France slaps sanctions on JN Chief Azhar. So when the UN Security Council's move to designate Maulana Masood Azhar as an international terrorist failed because of China's technical hold, now, France has, as a nation, slapped sanctions against the JEM chief, Jaish-e-Mohammed chief. So, it says that this is a prelude to national ban. So, it will be banned in the nation too. Then, on page 2, you have NGT directs Haryana chief secretary to review policy, submit report. So, the National Green Tribunal has directed Haryana chief secretary. The chief secretary is the topmost IAS officer in a state. So he has been directed to review the inspection policy of industries in the state. It is said further he was directed that slides here. So he was directed to submit a report on the same within 1 month. So this is the order by NGT. So it says the NGT says that the current policy is not in consonance with the mandate of the principles of precautionary and sustainable development of environmental law. It is said highly polluting industries as defined by Central Pollution Control Board are to be inspected once in 3 years. So that all that is not being done. Then on page 5 you have two suspended over fatal bridge collapse. So BMC has now ordered a re-audit of all Mumbai bridges, and even two persons have been suspended in this case too. So we got the news of this bridge collapse in which 6 people died and around 31 have been injured. Then this is Supreme Court sets aside life ban on Shri Sant. So Supreme Court has asked BCCI to review its punishment as such too. So this is former Indian cricketer who was banned for life in connection with the 2013 IPL spot fixing scandal. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is a fresh warning. So this talks about how India must recognize the human cost of poorly enforced environmental laws. So this is in context of the 6th edition of the Global Environment Outlook of UNEP. We had discussed this in news. So it spoke about how the unsustainable use of resources and extraction of resources and producing unmanageable quantities of waste is going to have a toll on the environment, which will result in a huge human cost to number of cases of ill health and high premature mortality, untimely death. So this is discussed in this editorial. And second editorial is slower, softer. So this is regarding Brexit. So whether it should be a soft Brexit or it should be slow Brexit. So that is, that has been ensured now because of the parliamentary vote. So British Prime Minister Theresa May also gets a hope that a hard Brexit can be avoided. So Parliament voted seeking a delay to the exit from European Union. So this has given British Prime Minister Theresa May a breather and a chance to push her exiting deal for Brexit. Then the lead article is The Jawan on the Border. So this talks about how the opposition, whether it can respond to a counter to British Prime Minister Modi's overarching nationalist script post Pulwama. So how those sentiments are being used by the party in power. And the article below is Partition, Freedom and Democracy. So this is regarding India-Pakistan conflict. It says the roots of this conflict can be found in the shared attitude of decision towards the past, of derision towards the past, that you know, the, how the partition happened, and you know, so all those aspects have decided our relations presently, the two countries' relations, and that is the root of the conflict. Then on Saturdays, there's a ground zero coverage on op-ed page, so one issue is covered, and today it is regarding emergence of Chennai's casteless collective. So it says that this shows how a growing interest is there in engaging with art, and there are talks about social and political issues. So this is regarding the musical tradition it this Chennai's casteless collective draw from, and the possibilities that lie ahead for them. This is it. They talk about art, social and political aspect. On page 8 you have Kharge refuses to attend Lokpal meet. So we have seen this earlier too, that when the Lokpal selection committee was meeting, the leader of the single largest party in opposition, Mallikarjun Kharge, was invited only to be part of the meeting, but he will not have any voting rights, because according to the Lokpal Act, who should be a member is leader of the opposition, while there is no present leader of the opposition in the parliament, because no party got 10%, 10% of the seats. So a party which has at least 10% of the seats becomes the leader of the opposition. So there are such provisions in the selection panel when opposition is included. This is the terminology used, leader of the opposition, and this is required in many other appointments too, not just in Lokpal appointment committee. So in other appointments, what the government has done is amendments have been done, and the leader of the opposition has been replaced by the phrase leader of the single largest party in opposition. But in case of Lokpal, it has not done that, and now again when Mallikarjun Kharge has been invited as the single leader of the single largest party in opposition, he said he will not attend the meet. Its government failed to amend Lokpal Act to include leader of the opposition party. And below you have India resents Pakistan offer on Kartarpur. So India is unhappy with the land encroachment and plan to introduce fee for pilgrims which Pakistan has put forth on Kartarpur corridor. And on international page, you have this coverage on the New Zealand attack on mosques. So signs point to a gunman steeped in far-right internet culture. So a white nationalist manifesto believed to have been posted online by the gunman refers to non-whites as invaders who threaten to replace white people. So this is the detail of this attack, which is there on front page too, the news from terror attack in New Zealand. Then on business page you have Goyal Etihad face off may cost jet dear. So Gulf Airlines, Etihad Airlines wants jet chairman and wife to exit post restructuring of jet. They reject terms set by Goyal. So this is going to for Jet Airways, which is under stress now. Restructuring plan has been proposed, but it seems there are differences now between the stakeholders. And here you have strong inflows help push rupee to a 6-month high. So foreign portfolio investments net buyers in equities have been at 4,323 crore rupees. So this has pushed rupee at a 6-month high. So it's the exchange rate of rupee against dollar. So it is at 69.1, that is highest since August 2018. Exports rise 2.44%, trade deficit narrows. So India's exports have also increased, merchandise exports grew in the month of Feb and imports have declined. So when exports rise and import declines, trade deficit narrows, because imports are always higher than exports, especially because of oil. And this is NCLAT refuses to stay SR steel sale to ArcelorMittal. So this was a landmark judgment which we saw of NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal, in which SR Steel sale was approved. The plan of ArcelorMittal was approved for SR Steel, but then the Ruya brothers, who are the owners of SR Steel, they said they would approach the appellate tribunal. So now they have approached the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, but it has refused to stay this sale, SR Steel sale to ArcelorMittal. Then on page 12 too, you have this news regarding National Company Law Appellate Tribunal. This is regarding Ericsson. So Supreme Court had asked Reliance Communication to pay Ericsson's dues within 4 weeks, and now Reliance Communication, when it approached NCLAT to direct SBI to release funds, NCLAT refused to give such direction. Then on the last page you have this is mosquito killing drug offers new tool for fighting malaria. So mosquito killing drug has been tested in Burkina Faso, which has reduced malaria cases by a fifth among children and could be an important new tool in the global fight against malaria. So this is important. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and enroll for the current affairs course for detailed video. And also you can download the PDFs which are uploaded there. So that is it. Thank you.